वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल सी हाउ टू प्रिपेयर डिवाइडेड पाउडर्स। एम, टू प्रिपेयर एंड सबमिट डिवाइडेड पाउडर्स। रिक्वायरमेंट, केमिकल्स, एस्पिरिन, पैरासिटामोल एंड कैफीन। देन apparatus, mortar and pestle, and weighing balance. So pharmaceutical powders are the traditional dosage form. Historically, this powder represent one of the oldest dosage form and is a solid dosage form which contain mixture of finely divided drugs or chemicals in a dry form meant for internal or external use. It is preparation in which drug is blended with other powder substances and used for internal or external purpose. Powder as a dosage form permits drugs to be reduced to fine state of the division, which often enhances their therapeutic activity and efficacy, increases of dissolution rate and or absorption. Divided powders are also found to be convenient for administering drugs that are excessively bitter, nauseous or otherwise offensive to taste. Although powders are not used nowadays extensively as a dosage form, they are widely used in the preparation of various dosage forms. Powder drug can be blended with other powder material like adhesives prior to fabrication into other solid dosage form such as a tablet or capsule. Powder drugs are frequently added to other ingredients to make ointment, paste, suppositories and others. Powder properties relevant to pharmaceutical formulation are single particle properties and bulk properties. Collectively, these include particle-particle interaction, powder morphology and mixing and blending. Properties of the powders depends upon type of mechanism of mixing, type of mixing equipment, and then minimizing the segregation tendencies. Advantages of pharmaceutical powders. Drugs that have to be given in a bulk can be best administered in a powder form by mixing them with food or drinks. Useful for the bulky drugs with large doses. Powders are more stable than liquid dosage form, hence many antibiotics and injections are manufactured as a powder for reconstitution in a respective vehicle. More convenient to swallow than tablet and capsule because you require to dissolve it into the water and then you can take it. Powder possesses good chemical stability as it is solid dosage form, that's why it is having a very good stability. Since powder are in the form of small particles, they offer a large surface area and are rapidly dissolved in the gastrointestinal tract, minimizing the problems of local irritation. Rapid dissolution powder facilitates rapid absorption. Highly compatible compared to liquid dosage form. Manufacturing of powder is economic, hence produce coat is quite low as compared to other dosage form, means only particle size reduction and mixing. So these are the steps for the dispensing this powder dosage form, that's why it is economic. Then disadvantages of pharmaceutical powders. Bulk powders are not suitable for the administering potent drug with low dose. Not suitable for drugs which are unstable in a normal atmospheric conditions. Powder form is not suitable for drugs that are inactivated in or cause a damage into the stomach. These should be presented as an enteric coated tablet. So such a type of the drugs which causes the gastric irritation or which are unstable into the gastric pH, so they required coating and we cannot dispense them into the powder dosage form. Then this powder dosage form is not suitable for the bitter, nauseous and corrosive drug if arminted or oral administration. The masking unpleasant taste may be problem with this type of the preparation. A method of attempting this is by formulating the powders into a pleasantly tasting or test masking test masked effervescent product, whereas tablet and capsule are a more common alternative for low dose products. Inaccuracy of dose in case of bulk powder may be there, inconvenient to carry, and they are susceptible to physical instability. Then classification of powder dosage form. So powders are classified for the internal use. Again, they are classified into two subclasses, that is divided powder and bulk powder. Then divided powders are consist of simple powders, then compound powders, powder enclosed into the sachets, and tablet triturates, while bulk powders include antacids and laxative. Then second major class of powder, that is powder for external use. Again, this class is subclassified into dusting powder. Dusting powder is having two subclasses, medicated dusting powder and surgical dusting powder. Then insufflation, then douche powder, then dendrophysis, and third major class, that is special powders. So these special powders include eutectic mixtures, then effervescent powders. Now we'll see divided powders, because we are going to prepare divided powder. So divided powders are single doses of powdered drugs individually wrapped in a cellophane or metallic foil or paper. The divided powder is more accurate dosage form than bulk powder because patient is not involved in a measurement of dose. Then cellophane and foil enclosed powders are better protected from the external environment until the time of administration than paper enclosed powders. Divided powders are commercially available in a foil, cellophane or paper packs. Again, they are classified into two subclasses. First class is simple powder and second is compound powder. So simple powder consists of only one active ingredients and suitable in a substances. If powder is in a crystalline form, then it is reduced to fine. For example, aspirin powder, calcium gluconate powder. Then second class of this divided powder is compound powder. It consists of mixture of more than one active ingredients and other constituents. Right now we are going to prepare compound powder. For example, aspirin, paracetamol and caffeine powder. So combination of these three is called as compound powder. So just we have to triturate all powders, get fine powder, then weigh a calculated amount of powder required for the single dose and then wrap into the individual packet, that is individual paper. Now we'll see drugs used in this divided powder. First is aspirin. Systemic name is acetyl salicylic acid. Molecular formula C9H8 O4, then molecular weight 180.157 gram per mole. Aspirin is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, which is predominantly used as an analgesic, antipyretic or anti-inflammatory drug. It is used to reduce pain, fever or inflammation. Aspirin given shortly after a heart attack decreases the risk of death. Aspirin is also used long term to help or to prevent further heart attacks or ischemic strokes and blood clots in the people at a high risk. It may also decrease the risk of certain types of cancers, particularly colorectal cancer. For a pain or fever, effects typically begin within 30 minutes. Aspirin is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, and that's why it works similarly to other NSAIDs, but also suppresses normal functioning of platelets. Now, second drug, that is paracetamol, its systemic name is acetaminophen, molecular formula C8H8NO2, molecular weight 151.16. It is typically used for a mild or moderate pain relief. It is often sold in a combination with other medication, such as in many cold medication. Paracetamol is also used for severe pain, such as a cancer pain, pain after surgery, in a combination with opioid pain medication. It is typically used either by mouth or rectally, but is also available by injection into vein. Effects last between 2 to 4 hours. Then third drug, that is caffeine. It is chemical name 1,3,7-trimethylpurine-2,6-dione. This is molecular formula. Then molecular weight 194.19 gram per mole. Caffeine is naturally occurring xanthan derivative used as a CNS and respiratory stimulant and as a mild diuretics. Caffeine is often combined with analgesic or with other ergot alkaloids for the treatment of migraine and other types of headaches. Then formulation of single dose of divided powder. Formula for the single dose is aspirin 300 mg, paracetamol 200 mg and caffeine 50 mg. Okay, this is the formula for the single dose, but we require to prepare 4 doses. So by calculating this, 300 mg required for the single dose, then x mg will be required for the 4 doses. So after calculating, I got a value that is 1.2 gram. Then similarly here I have calculated value for the paracetamol, and obtained value for the paracetamol is 0.8 gram. And then for the caffeine, 50 mg is required for the single dose and 0.2 gram is required for the 4 doses. Then our formula for this 4 doses. So we require to take 1200 mg or 1.2 gram of aspirin, then 800 mg or 0.8 gram of paracetamol, and 200 mg caffeine. So this is our working formula for the four doses. Then procedure: powder the ingredients separately, then weigh out of required amount of ingredients using butter paper for one extra powder, then triturate the powder by adding them in a geometrical ratio. weigh out the prescribed number or divide them equally by making a slab on the tile using scale. Then wrap each powder in a double wrapped packet. Now we'll see actual demonstration how to prepare this divided powder.
Now we'll see how to prepare and submit divided powder. Here we are preparing analgesic and antipyretic divided form of the powder. For that purpose we are using aspirin, paracetamol and caffeine. So for the 4 doses, we require aspirin 1.2 gram, then paracetamol 0.8 gram and caffeine 0.2 gram. By trituration method, we are going to mix all these powder with the help of mortar and pestle. In trituration method, particle size reduction and mixing simultaneously going on. Now I am adding my third powder, that is paracetamol powder. So uniform mixture of our powder is ready to use. Now we'll weigh it into the single doses and then we'll pack it. Balance and then weigh required quantity of your powder for the single dose. Now in our case it is 0.55. 0.55 gram. So ready. Similarly, I am weighing other 3 doses. Now second dose is ready. Then you have to pack it. So you have to make a first fold of this paper in such a way, then make a second fold from this side. Again fold it in this way and this folded part you have to insert into the second fold.
then our first dose is ready. Then you have to pack it with the help of rubber. Okay, so first dose is ready. Similarly, I am going to fold other doses and selling into the butter paper. This divided form of the powder we can dispense into the partitioned box for the secondary packaging. Now in this way, 4 doses of analgesic and antipyretic powder. In this way, 4 doses of divided powders are ready to use.
So in this way, I'm ready with my divided doses of powders. Now I'm putting these powders into this partitioned box in this way. So this box is having a different compartments, and in each compartment you have to fill this powder. Okay, then you require to label it. So your label should contain name of powder, then each dose contain how much amount of ingredients or how much amount of drugs, then manufacturing date, expiry date, then manufacturing LIC number, then mention category, then direction for the use. You require to dissolve this powder and then dissolve this powder into the water, and then you can take by dissolving it. So such a type of the direction you have to mention on that label. Then storage conditions, keep in a cool place, and last is the manufacturing by. So such a label you require to prepare, and that label you have to stick on this partition box. So here I have stuck this label on this partition box, and in this way I am ready with my divided powder. Result: 4 doses of divided powders are prepared and submitted. Then we'll see synopsis viva questions. First question: what type of the powder it is, okay, which we have prepared right now. So it is a compound powder because it consists of more than one API. What do you understand by analgesic and antipyretic? Analgesics are the agents which relieve a pain by acting centrally to elevate pain threshold without disturbing consciousness or altering other sensory modalities. Then antipyretic drugs which reduces elevated body temperature. What do you understand by keep in a cool place? So it means that the preparation should be stored at not more than 15 degree centigrade. Then fourth question, what is the dose of paracetamol? So it is from 300 milligram to 1000 milligram depending upon weight of that particular individual. Define the term trituration. It is the process of reducing substances to fine particle by rubbing them in a mortar with the help of pestle. This process helps in a mixing of fine powder as well as particle size reduction, and it is called as trituration. Then next question, classify powders for external use. First, dusting powder. The dusting powder classified into two subclasses, that is medicated dusting powder, surgical dusting powder, then encephalation, douche powder, then dendrophysis, this is all about divided powder. Thank you.